This video presents information on the adverse effects of tobacco use on health. The evidence is overwhelming. There is no safe level of exposure to tobacco smoke. Any exposure to tobacco smoke, even an occasional cigarette or exposure to secondhand smoke, is harmful. The most effective strategy for reducing the risk of tobacco-related disease and death is to never smoke, and if you do smoke, to quit. Over the decades, studies have proven that smoking causes many diseases, including at least 12 types of cancer and numerous acute and chronic diseases. Tobacco smoking harms almost all systems of the human body. Smoking causes cancer throughout most of the respiratory tract, including the oropharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, and lungs. In the gastrointestinal tract, smoking causes cancer in the esophagus, stomach, and colon. It causes liver cancer and pancreatic cancer. In the genitourinary system, smoking causes cancer of the kidney, bladder, and cervix. Smoking also causes acute myeloid leukemia in the blood. Most people are familiar with the respiratory diseases caused by tobacco smoking. These include chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, and chronic respiratory symptoms, such as chronic cough, phlegm, wheezing, and dyspnea. Smoking exacerbates asthma, reduces lung function, and impairs lung growth in childhood and adolescence. It also causes acute respiratory illnesses, like pneumonia. Smoking is responsible for many cardiovascular diseases as well, including coronary heart diseases, stroke, and abdominal aortic aneurysm. Particularly concerning for developing countries is the effect on tuberculosis. Smoking increases the risk of tuberculosis infection, risk of death from tuberculosis, and risk of recurring tuberculosis. Tobacco smoking can cause sexual dysfunction, including erectile dysfunction in men and reduced fertility in women. Women who smoke during pregnancy increase their risk for complications, such as ectopic pregnancy, preeclampsia, placenta previa, placental abruption, premature rupture of membranes, preterm delivery, and stillbirth. For the developing fetus, there is an increased risk of orofacial cleft, fetal growth restriction, and low birth weight. For postmenopausal women, smoking increases the risk of hip fractures and causes lower bone density. Other adverse health effects associated with tobacco smoking include diabetes mellitus, peptic ulcer disease, rheumatoid arthritis, periodontitis, and eye diseases, such as blindness, cataracts, and macular degeneration. It also increases adverse surgical outcomes, such as slowed wound healing and respiratory complications. Smokeless tobacco use also contributes to illness and disease. The use of smokeless tobacco causes oral cancer, precancerous oral leukoplakia, oral lesions, gingival recession, and loss of tooth structure. In India, where smokeless tobacco use is more common than smoking, it is noteworthy that oral cancers are the most common fatal cancer in men, followed by stomach cancer and lung cancer. 1/3 of the total cancer burden in India is attributed to oral cancer. Smokeless tobacco typically contains nicotine and is not a safe alternative to smoking. The tobacco-related diseases just discussed are diseases caused by active tobacco use. However, exposure to secondhand smoke has been shown to cause diseases in nonsmokers, including lung cancer, coronary heart disease, and stroke. Children who live with parents who smoke have an increased risk of asthma, chronic respiratory symptoms, wheezing illnesses, and lower respiratory illnesses. They also have an increased risk of middle ear diseases, such as otitis media and middle ear effusion. Infants exposed to secondhand smoke have an increased risk of sudden infant death syndrome, or SIDS. There are numerous health benefits to quitting tobacco use, many of which occur in the short term. For example, after the first 20 minutes of quitting smoking, your heart rate and blood pressure drop. After 12 hours, the carbon monoxide in your blood drops to normal. Within 2 weeks to 3 months, your circulation improves and your lung function increases. Within 1 to 9 months, coughing and shortness of breath decrease, and your lungs are able to clear mucus more easily, thus decreasing your risk of infection. In the long term, the risk of smoking-related diseases decreases after quitting. After 1 year, your risk of coronary heart disease decreases by 50%. After 5 years, your risk of cancer of the mouth, throat, esophagus, and bladder decreases by 50%. After 10 years, your risk of death from lung cancer decreases by 50%. Also, your risk of cancer of the larynx and pancreas decreases. After 15 years, your risk of coronary heart disease and stroke decreases to that of a non-smoker. And after 20 years, the risk of pancreatic cancer decreases to that of a non-smoker. In closing, the health consequences from tobacco use are serious and life-threatening. While there has been tremendous progress over the past half century in identifying and exploring the harms of tobacco use, efforts are still needed to further reduce tobacco use. Sustained and comprehensive efforts and policies that focus on preventing youth initiation and encouraging smokers to quit are integral to saving lives and reducing the burden of tobacco use. The next video will discuss the role of global tobacco control policies in more detail.